We got to get into some football. We see the people watching. Oh, man. Oh, man. Mr. Kyle Yacy talking to you, Nick. And Nick, let's talk about the loss you're getting deep this week. Oh.
Ooh. Take it. It's okay, Kyle. Kyle's from Canada. They don't understand all Canada. You know, the intricacies of stuff. Come on. No, it's fine. Our neighbor to the north is.
Oh, yeah. What's going on, Ass saying? Hey, let's get into it right away. Dylan, I'm going to come to you. The Thursday night football game. Last year's defending Super Bowl champs, the Rams, played what many people project as this year's favorites to go to the Super Bowl, if not to win it. But it was not the game that we all thought it would be. The Bills crushed the Rams 31-10. Dylan, were you expecting this, or what were your thoughts, man?
It's a very interesting game because listen, at halftime it was 10-10, and then it's like, oh, 17-10. It's going to be a close game. And then Matthew Stafford threw a couple interceptions. Jalen Ramsey had an awful game. Got absolutely murdered. Had a lot of perfect passer rating against him. Yeah. And then the Rams just never was able to get back to where they were in the first half because Allen Robinson was doing nothing. Van Jefferson was out. Cam Akers was doing nothing. Whole three carries for 0 yards.
Yeah.
So as soon as they stopped Cooper Kupp, the Rams' offense was just gone.
Yeah, you're absolutely right. And that was weird, man. That's weird. But I want to spotlight on one thing you said. And Nathan, I'm coming to you. You and I talked about this before. You know, there was one guy that we know year after year has been talking. And he's dubbed one of the greatest corners of all time. Or not of all time, but at least in the league right now. And Jalen Ramsey. But like Dylan was saying, burnt toast, man. He got burned a bunch of times. Diggs sat there and got in his face one time and said, I don't hear you talking. Like, talk to me about that. I'm not going to overreact, but has he fallen off or, last year the same thing happened? What do you think, Nate?
No, I don't think he's fallen off. You know, it's we still got 15 games of football left. Jalen Ramsey, he does like to chirp, but when you do put him in check, yeah, you do. He is nowhere to be found. I think he's going to be better next week. This was he just got punched in the mouth, and I'm glad Allen Turb did it. So, I've seen that before from Jalen Ramsey when Steve Smith, when he was a Raven, he checked him. I mean, Jalen Ramsey is just one of those guys, you can't let him get in his head. Yeah. If you get in his head, you've beaten him. Bro. It's just one of those, you gotta let your play do the talking. So, I'm glad that it got put in check to make him start working signs and be better.
Oh yeah. Well, we'll see how, like you said, and that was a great point. First game of the year, let's not overreact. Buffalo is legit. Stephon Diggs is one of the best in the leagues, and he proved it in that game. But, I want to focus on the Rams, Nick. I honestly do, okay, man. Like, Matt Stafford, we know he's been dealing with the tendonitis. We know he's been dealing with that, but he threw three picks. What's his name? Dylan talked about Cam Akers, who really did not do anything. A lot of people in fantasy were talking about he's supposed to be this guy this year, the sleeper. Kupp had his normal day, 13 catches for 128 yards, but who else was doing much of anything? You know what I mean? Like, what happened to the Rams, man?
Well, I was kind of – one thing that kind of puzzled me was that Akers didn't even play in the first quarter.
Yeah.
Like, Henderson got all the reps in that first quarter. Like, why did that even happen, Mr. McVay? Like, what was going on there that – because like you said, everybody came into this year with Akers as the number one, and they even said Akers was, the featured back, and all of a sudden he doesn't play the whole first quarter.
Right.
Like, maybe there's something else there we don't know about. Because like you said, he had three carries and managed 0 yards. So – and then McVay says, well, he has to take advantage of his opportunities. Well, if you don't play for an entire quarter, how the hell are you going to take advantage of your opportunities? Like you said, by the time he got in there, like, this Buffalo defense is not terrible by any means. They're a very good defense. So you're going to sit there and tell me that, well, the guy doesn't play the whole first quarter, and then he comes in and he didn't take advantage of his opportunities. He had three carries. So I don't know. But like you said, as a whole, the offense was a disaster after that first half. Like, I don't know what happened in the second half. Matthew Stafford looked like, his third year in Detroit, Matthew Stafford. Just throwing the ball everywhere, and everybody else is catching it but his players. And then you had and then he criticized, apparently, Allen Robinson for not going after that jump ball in the end zone.
That was so
I'm saying, like, But there's a video going around where he apparently does Sean McVay. He didn't even go for the ball. And it's like, dude, you threw up a toss-up in the damn end zone in the back of the end zone. Really? I mean, I know guys are supposed to fight for balls, but come on, bro. Yeah. Like, just so there was a lot going on there. The Rams, I mean, I assume the Rams will rebound. Yeah. I don't think, you know, they're not a horrible team by any means, but you got spanked that Thursday night. You take the loss, you take the whooping, and hopefully you move on from that and, you know, you get better. But, yeah, you got spanked, and there's just no way around it.
Now, look, real quick, I do want to ask you, because you did mention your old guy, Mr. Allen Robinson.
Yeah.
Talk to me about that. Was that, you know, when he was in Chicago, it's a, you know, big fish, little market. Now he's the Rams. He's a little fish, well, big market. Like, what happened to him? Because he fell off.
See, that's the thing, though. Allen Robinson has actually, that's carried him, though. There was times where he, you know, he did hustle in Chicago, and people said, this guy's a lazy receiver. Like, he doesn't always go after it. He doesn't know, you know. He's lackadaisical. His routes are not always the best. I mean, but this is the first time, really, he's played with a good quarterback. So everybody was willing to see what Allen was going to do. And I won't lie, I drafted him. The reason Kyle is talking all that crap he is to me is because I have 2.2 points because I had both Cam Akers and Allen Robinson. And Allen Robinson had one catch for 12 yards. So that's why Kyle's saying he's going to beat me this week. But when I turned it around on him with Jonathan Taylor and the boys, he's still going to lose this week. So, Kyle, start crying in your beer. But anyways, wow. I digress. I'll be anxious to see what happens with Allen Robinson because, again, there is a lot of knocks against him, but he's supposed to be better, and we'll see if Matthew Stafford and him make a connection. That's it.
We shall see.
The Rams' offensive line as well was so bad.
They were
6 or 7 sacks without ever being blitzed once.
Yeah.
Von Miller had 3 or so. It was awful. So it's like, especially with like Cam Akers only having 3 carries for 0 yards, he has to run behind that O line and has a whole 3 carries to try to do something behind that O line. So they really
that's what I said.
And a lot of people,
they don't have Von Miller defense. So you look at like a whole new identity with the Rams. He didn't really spend much in free agency. I mean, they really couldn't spend money because they're tied down. So. I mean, I think a lot of it's just more of chemistry issues. I think they'll get it straightened out these next couple weeks. So,
Kyle's just out here. Got my fire extinguisher on standby. No fires this fall. Oh, my guy. Oh, my goodness. Let's go. Yeah, look, I agree with you guys. I mean, we will see how it all plays out coming into this year. Yes, it was not a good start. And we know about McVay. McVay has never – been under 500 in his career. He has never lost a season opener, but he did this week. So we'll see how he rebounds. Cooper Kupp still did what he did, but like you said, with the O-line, Whitworth is out. And on that left side, it's a lot of young talent, rookies and younger guys. Then you got Vaughn on the other side, who is becoming a mercenary. Wherever he goes, he just does a little bit here and there, but he still has us thinking he's one of the top guys. So we'll see what Buffalo does. That's what we expected from Buffalo. But the Rams, interesting. Very interesting.
Thanks for watching. If you liked that clip, be sure to check out the other great content from the Let's Talk Football community. And as always, please like, subscribe, and hit that notification bell so you'll be notified when more great content like this becomes available.